to that. You know, cause that's what it is. It's just like nicking certain styles of music. I just like Latin music. It's a great thing that Aieto showed me. Now, this was no pressure, right? I'm doing an album at George Martin's place, there, Lyndhurst. And it's with Georgie Faye. It's all a thing about Ronnie Scott, because he just died. And Flora Purim, which is his wife, is a Brazilian singer. Aieto came in like that, and he showed me the groove to play on the track, and sat next to me. This is a massive guy who played Weather Report, Miles Davis, Aieto Maria. And he showed me this groove. It's just so simple, so simple. But you know, having him there, no matter what you play, you know, it's great. And it's called a slow bolero. And he said, right, now think of it as the Quavers as like a jazz thing for the fills, right? And imagine if I say play a nice slow 2-3 like a boss note, but you'd be like struggling your ass off to try and make something out of that, right? And the way he showed me, and it's lovely, but I'll show you, he added something else that is hard to do. It sounds really simple, it's hard to do, and he's putting the hi-hat on beat 3. Killer. That sounds stupid, doesn't it? All you gotta do is put your hi-hat on beat 3. And then when you do a fill, you swing it. Da do do da 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 do do. Get your in da 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 do do. But not all the time, don't overdo it, but play that just for that one beat in the bar, and you go. It's a killer groove. It's simple. The simplest things can be hard, you know. and that's what opened my ears up to playing Latin things with a jazz influence, you know, that swing thing. Lovely. It's called a slow bolero. It's like I play the boss note. And it hypnotizes you when you hear a band doing that. And the dynamics you can play. I'll do something. I used to play a lot with a singer called Mark Murphy. I did about 10, 15 years with him all over the world. And he used to do a lot of Brazilian stuff. I'll show you some of the dynamics. I won't do all the samples. Playing every beat of that, at least you're actually sort of giving the illusion that there's just something of continuity. It's the same with the jazz thing. Not doing that all the time. I've nicked so many areas of music and tried to, you know, sometimes successfully, but you know, try to use them in appropriate moments. You know, like I don't play like the Bonham stuff if you play with somebody like Johnny Griffin, you know, the bebop thing. You know, you've got to choose your moment. It's not like being an impressionist or something like tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be, you know, I try and, yeah, but when I see a session or a musical situation, I think, God, and the style of the music, and there will be somebody that I'll be really into that will be suiting that style of music. And I don't try to do an impression, but I get the influence of that on how they would approach that, like certain things, like Roy Haynes is playing, or whatever, different sessions. It could